Okay, I'm gonna make the video of making the henna on the hair. Okay, I'm kind of disappointed that I have to make a video about the henna on the hair, because it's something that, I don't know, it just brings up the realm of all of the other products and on this store available that are not natural and that are toxic. And so it's kind of a dredge of what a bummer. Anyway, it comes out and it's kind of green powder, and you add water, a little hot water, and then you put it on your hair. And after a while, 20 or 30 minutes, you take it off, and then it stays there for like the 30 days, or it could stay there for 3 months, depending how long you held it on your hair and how thick. But it's a natural, it's just like an oxide. I suppose it's an oxide. I'm not sure, actually. It's a powder, and I guess I can use it for painting also. So, ooh, don't tell anyone. They may get a grump up on me. Take it off the market, you know what I'm saying? So anyway, there it is. It's a green goo. And I don't know, why does this have to go on? Why do these big coiffure places have to still continue dumping toxics into the oceans, into the rivers, the lakes, and the streams? I don't know, why can't we just use some stupid henna and be happy with it? You know what I'm saying? It comes in the chestnut. It has a pamphlet in here. You want me to read the pamphlet? Says you has a noir, you can go straight black even if you're needing that color. You can be the brune, which is like, I guess, brown of some sort. You can be also the other, no, there are two browns here listed. How confusing. Auburn also. Now are we, oh my goodness, jittery on the color. Oh my gosh. Yeah, auburn is the lighter, I believe so. Then you have the, what is this other one here? It says it has the clair. I'm making terrible videos lately. Any type of reading or looking down at the objects, it just gives me a big head, I know. It's terrible. What is this next one? It says it has a, I'm not even sure how it could be a clair. Did anybody understand how it could be a clear? Why would I put clear on my head? That's not making sense. Anyway, then there is the blonde. And for some reason, out of all of these colors, I received the... The clear, they're calling this the chestnut. Don't understand why. But yeah, so you have the chestnut. Oh, there you go. They call the auburn chestnuts, and they call the clair the light chestnut. And then they have blonde, and the blonde is an interesting one. I'm not even sure how that would be possible. It says copper blonde is going to get out, a copper blonde. So, yeah, so it's a non-toxic, and it doesn't peroxide, it doesn't bleach, it doesn't damage the hair cuticle, doesn't strip it, doesn't cause any kind of danger to it. You know, that's the main thing you always have to think of when you are getting excited about your hair colors. Yeah, you don't want to damage your hair, otherwise you'll have nothing to paint in the future if you get it paint happy. Yeah, what are those things they call them? The permanents. You're gonna get the permanent. When you're getting the permanent. I remember once I asked the beautician man, can I have a permanent? And he said, no, you cannot have a permanent. I'm like, what? I'm here, customer, I want to order the permanent. He would not let me have the permanent. Not for your hair, not now, not ever. So all right, no curlies for you. Yeah, I gotta watch all of those products. I guess they go in and they do terribles. They weaken the shaft of the hair. So yeah, okay. So it does feel mildly like, well, maybe it's not the social aspect, you know, the henna. I'm not at the social salon moment, you know. Oh, they can do it there also if you need that. If that's your requirement, you can have the social aspect. They can absolutely go in henna. That is not a problem. So it doesn't take them out of business at all. If that is your need and necessity there. Yeah. But I'm very happy. I'm very happy to have it there at the little bioorganic store. And it's a shame I had to go to the bioorganic store for it. It's a shame that would not be there at any major supermarket immediately. It's a little annoying. Yeah, so I started looking at major supermarkets. I'm like, what are you doing? You know, don't you have culpability at this point? At some rationality, you all have to stop. You have to stop your little support of this business and that business, that no matter and no why, you are offering toxic products to the planet. You are having them as sale. And so oddly, you are setting yourself up for a massive, massive lawsuit. And I, for one, would be a signer of that one to sue them and put them out of business because that is a crime. Any products that you're offering on the store shelves that are toxic down the drain waters, any products that you are offering that are poisons, that are down the drain waters. Any products. Yeah, you deserve all to be put out of business. Unless you like to have hermaphrodite children.